I always dreamed of like coming to fucking LA and like going to Hollywood and making it big. As an Australian kid, like I didn't know how I was gonna do it or what was gonna happen. I was like fucking 7 years old saying, one day I'm gonna be in LA and one day I'm gonna be like a famous rapper and shit. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna make it happen somehow. I feel like I manifested this whole shit. I'm trying to get you on your road tonight. Tap a little bit. You know it. You tell me that you with it, gotta show me. I'm trying to let go, can you hold me down? I'm from Sydney, Australia. I kind of had like a crazy childhood.
Yeah, so I'm living. This is 2018. I'm on the blow up mattress. Little heater, you know what I mean?
Me and my family didn't have a house and shit like that. But then it got to a point, you know, where we had nowhere to go. We were like staying on my mom's friend's couch and shit like that. And bro was like literally cooking meth like right next to us. Shit was getting really hectic. I had to watch my mom do a lot of shit to survive and keep us like fed and shit. So music was definitely like a way of keeping my head clear. I used to type up like Eminem type beats or like Kendrick Lamar type beats and just rap to it. At first it was on some like therapy shit. But then after that, it was like a realization like, damn, we need to get money. I needed to go out and do something about it. I wake up and come on, blessings. Never stressing,
I wake up, I pray to God, lead me in the right direction. I heard like 5 seconds of this song called Blessings. And I was like what the fuck?
How old is this kid now? Like, he's 14, and he's like, holy shit.
This is the next thing, you know what I'm saying? And I was just telling Peter, my brother, like, man, I gotta find this kid.
Juice had a tour in Australia, and when I got there, the first thing I did was link up with Leroy. I saw the potential. It wasn't just the music, it was the hustle, because he just wasn't a regular, oh, what can you do for me, kid? Like, he acted like he ran Australia at the age of 13.
Pete told me to come to his hotel room, and I, like, opened the door, and it was Juice. Holy shit. Me and my friends are just, like, looking at each other in the room, like, holy shit, holy shit, holy shit. I just realized, like, fuck, I'm ready to do this shit. Let's go. I used to pray for some better days. 10 years later, I'm in L.A. L.A. is crazy.
One take, one soft stick.
When I came out here, I ended up staying with Juice and Pete.
He just used to watch Juice work all the time. Like, Juice in the studio every day, like, making songs every day, all day. Roy picked that up.
He gave me a lot of advice about just this whole industry shit and just how to make it easier for myself in the future. I, like, got mom and my little brother out to L.A. and we got a little house and shit. I love having my family here because this place is fucking insane. It's like the devil. My younger brother's 3 years younger than me. He's the GOAT. He's a little legend.
I remember back home in Australia, you'd be like rapping and shit. To
now
mom.
I'm like doing like the real shit?
Kinda, yeah.
I believe I'm one of the hardest workers out there. We said I was, but you were the cause.
For every little feeling, I'm feeling the size. And now look, and now that reference I told you to keep, try to put that down. I don't know, I'm gonna see how it flows.
My whole life is work. Some people call me kind of crazy because they're like, dude, you're 17, like just fucking have fun and just like go and be a fucking teenager. And I'm just like, no. I want to be the biggest artist in the world. And I think being the biggest artist in the world comes with a lot of sacrifices, like taking care of your body. You know, I'm just trying to do this shit as best as I can while I'm young. I feel like if I get through this little bit of pain now, it's gonna be easier for me in the future.
Yeah, and cut the beat when I say that. Yeah, let me hear that.
I was in the studio with him probably 3 weeks ago. He spent probably 40 minutes just going over the same line in his music.
For life, I go get, for life, for life, go get, for life, go get, fuck, go get.
That's a person that wants to be the greatest. Pull up. In a yellow Lambo like Pikachu. My teacher said I wouldn't be shit, now look at you. I know you somewhere down bad, cause I just
paid your old check on a pair of some Jimmy Choo. Man, I'm pretty proud of you.
Hey, man.
Yeah, LA, like.
You said you're proud of me?
Yeah.
Thanks. Proud of you. Success, shit. As long as my family's good, as long as my money's right, as long as I'm happy, that's success to me. As long as the circle tight, then I'm good on guard.